Okay. Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. If you're new here, hello, my name is Lindsay. And if you couldn't tell by the title, I'm going to be doing a Get Ready With Me today. And I am honestly really excited about it because not only is it a New Year's Get Ready With Me, which essentially means we're almost done with 2020, but... Okay, so I realized that when this is getting posted, also don't mind the face mask, but that it is practically February, so just disregard that while watching this video, just to get ready with me. Cool. I'm also dressing up, which again, I have not done very much in 2020. So I'm just really excited, thought I'd hop into this. I'm just currently up in Muskoka with my boyfriend's family. And so that's kind of why we're getting dressed and dressing up, because we were like, why not? There's nothing else to do. So yeah, let's just hop into it. I do still have to moisturize, I already toned, but I'm just gonna be using the Sunday Riley Acne Treatment Facial Oil. I just find in the winter time, oils are just so much better for my skin. I find I have really, I have like mixed skin. Like in the summer, I'm like definitely way more oily. But then in the winter, my skin gets so dry. So I just find like using an acne treatment facial oil keeps my skin clear yet still moisturized, which is exactly what I need. Okay, so next is primer. The primer that I like to use is the Porefessional primer, but the hydrate primer. Once again, in the winter, my skin is super, super dry. So any way I can make it a little bit more hydrated so that my makeup looks dewy rather than dry and crackly is definitely what I'll be leaning towards in terms of products, which is why I absolutely love this product. It's just great. Okay, skin is feeling good. So I like to mix my concealers. These have been my two favorites for the past couple of years now. The first one is the Maybelline, I think it's the Age Rewind one. It's kind of the one that everyone loves to use. This is a little bit darker. And then in the winter, I like to use this Laura Mercier one, but I self-tanned a couple days ago on my face. So I'm kind of in the middle right now. So I'm going to use a few of these, a bit of both to do my makeup. Perfect. Keeping myself organized when I'm done using it. Plop it back. So then I just wet my beauty blender and I just go for it. And then just to kind of set everything, I use my banana setting powder. It's kind of translucent powder that I really like to use. It doesn't really affect the color of anything. And I usually just put on the areas where I put any concealer on, just so it doesn't look too cakey once again. Okay, so now we're getting into the good stuff. So I'm just gonna pull my hair back for some of this. Okay, so now we're gonna get into bronzer. I just got this one for Christmas and I've really just been wanting it for a while. I've heard great things, and that is the contour wand from Charlotte Tilbury. I think the shade I'm using is medium dark. I'm a pretty, you can't tell right now, but I'm usually a pretty tanned person. I'd say I have like olive toned skin. So if you have similar skin to me, I would definitely recommend this shade. Okay. That should be good. This product is just so great because it just blends so nicely, yet it looks so natural. And once again, because it's kind of like a liquidy cream product, it's not cakey, which is what I look for in the winter. And this one, you blend, but you also blend up into the scalp. Just so there's no weird lines, especially if you pull your hair back. And then I just like to set it with kind of like a shimmery bronzer. This one's by Pixi in the shade Summertime. It's just a really nice shimmery bronzer. I am big on blending, so then I just take another brush and I just kind of blend it all out.
Okay, so now on to my favorite part, which is blush. So this company is called Dirty Little Secret Cosmetics, and this blush is really, really nice, like shimmery, champagne-y, not champagne-y, but it has like this champagne like undertone to it, but it's a very like light pinky blush. I just love it, and it's in the shade Prosecco. So I'm gonna be taking the Nude Sticks blush in Sunkissed. I'm just gonna put that a little on my nose and just a little here as well. Next, I'm gonna be using Quo Beauty's Illuminating Drops in the shade Glow Getters. Right there. And I also put a little on my eyes. And this one I just blend first with my fingers. Okay, so I'm quickly gonna do my brows now. I'm using Selena Gomez's Rare Beauty Brow Pencil. I love this pencil just because you really don't need a lot in order to create the design that you're looking for, just because it is so pigmented. First brush out my eyebrows. Might have to do this off camera. Okay, I'm doing very simple eye makeup, nothing crazy. Okay, so as a base, I'm just gonna be using a MAC paint pot in the color All That Glitters. And then I'm just gonna be taking this other shade by a company called Ibby, I believe, and Yoga Pants. It looks like this, it's a little bit more purpley. And I'm also just gonna kind of be putting that in the outer corner of my lid. And I'm gonna take this bigger blending brush and I'm just going to use that and kind of blend that all in. No, that was almost a disaster. Okay, so I wanna be a little bit smoky tonight too, so I'm taking this Trastique, I think it's a black eyeliner. So I'm just gonna take this and kind of brush it under my waterline, and then I'm gonna smudge it out. Definitely looks smoky. Now I'm just gonna curl my lashes quickly and apply this mascara, which is called Complex Culture. Now on to the final step, which is lips. I'm going to be lining my lips first. I think I'm gonna go with Store by MAC. And then I'm just going to put a little bit of lip balm on quickly. I find it just helps blend things in a bit easier. And then I ring it in. And then I'm just taking this lip oil. It's kind of like lip gloss lip oil from Clarins. I absolutely love this stuff. Okay. And then when my mascara dries, this is another little thing that I like to do. I just curl them once more, and then sometimes I'll go over it with a little bit more mascara just to add a little bit more volume. Okay, there you have it. Here's the makeup, nothing crazy. The lighting is a little off right now because it's dark, so I'm using like just normal lighting, but I'll insert some more normal photos so you can see kind of what it looks like. But yeah, this is the makeup. Onto the hair. Okay, so this lighting is a little horrific, but this is the curling wand that I'll be using. It is just the Numi wand, and I'm just gonna be curling my entire hair. I'll give you a chance.
Hi guys, so I realized I forgot to film an outro for this video, so I just wanted to say thank you so much for watching. I hope you guys enjoyed. And I also just want to say thank you for over 600 subscribers. It's the little milestones, so just thanks for subscribing. And I'm excited to start uploading more frequently, so expect that. Bye guys!